Hi, this is Jeff Fletcher here with round two of a holiday cube draft I've been playing. It looks like I've got a completely rubbish starting hand. I've only landed a Master Core and I'm on the draw, so I guess I will not keep this hand. I'm going to mulligan it. This hand's not exactly great either, but I'm going to keep it because I don't like going to five. Hopefully draw something to make this, to redeem it a bit, make it more exciting. So my opponent looks aggressive, although he's made a Blood Crypt, and I don't think he's making a play with that. I was thinking for a second he was making a play. Yo, another 5-drop. Wow, cool. So that sucks. Hopefully I draw some of the many, many 3-drops or accelerants in this deck, and my hand's going to look a little less ludicrous, but that is a thing about fives. Nice mana, like double dual land. Oh, a Mesmeric Fiend, huh? So I guess you can see how much my keeps suck now. I guess as a bonus, a Mesmeric Fiend isn't exactly a crazy fast play. So my opponent knows I have some good stuff. Consecrated Sphinx is worse than usual here because my opponent's in the Doomblade colours, so that's he's more likely to have a good, viable thing to do against it. At least the Fiends implies a semi-slow strategy, although Bloodsoaked Champion implies fast, and so does that. So right. Things are looking bad for a hero, not gonna lie. There's a massive beat for six coming my way, but I can slow my opponent down a tiny bit. However, Plowunder is total rubbish here, and Freylaze is looking pretty poor. This Una's Prowler, like, sure, I can discard to end up, well, whatever. This is pretty galling. Oh, Olivia, I guess I do memory lapse that. Yeah, that, no. Just go away. Like, beating me up for six is already good enough, dude. Okay, not even playable. Oh, yeah, sure. That was like the super quickest game ever. Yeah, I could have drawn some more not relevant cards. As it turned out, six lands of Master Core might have been amazing here. Although no, he would have Mesmeric Fiend the Master Core, so actually it wouldn't have been. I'm just kind of feeling like it would have been. Yeah, it could take that corner. Yeah, sure. Okay. If I had a removal, it might have been great, but no. So back to the sideboard. Well, I didn't see really hardly any of my opponent's deck. I don't know if Reclamation Sage is good. I know it doesn't seem great. I know my opponent has Olivia, which is really mean. It makes me want to go the Planeswalker route to smashing the opponent. I think most of the cards I have are fine. My opponent does seem to have a number of X1s in the attack slot. Maybe that makes Grand Architect a little bit better, but I don't know. I feel like I don't get exactly a lot of value out of Grand Architect, and it's hard to cast the Reclamation Sage, so maybe I just stick that way for now. Yeah, that game was just useless. It makes me wish I could have splashed red. I just need to draw a good opener there. I don't think that was the deck. I don't think it was really me. I've ditched a bad opener and kept a really mediocre opener. Yeah, there wasn't a lot I could do. I'll stick. So I'll play first. This hand's better. It's not great. I really want an accelerant. Do I want to mulligan this? I guess not. Any land lets me make a Polukranos, which seems good-ish. I'm gonna keep. I think this is really borderline. I'm not very happy with it. The only thing I would say is there are cards, for instance, Mana Crypt, which I could draw that make this hand fantastic. So there's a Bloodsoaked Champion. That's cool. Got to expect that. I got a Reclamation Sage. So I get attacked, huh? Yep, I'll wear it. Okay, there is a target for Reclamation Sage, and it's a very, very good one. So I know that's in the cube now. Oh, this guy is just revolting against me. He's so good. Wow, that is pretty outrageous. So even though this is a really good play, I still feel like I'm just a million light years behind anywhere that would be regarded as doing okay in this game. Yeah, okay then. Like, just yield to the damn thing. Yes. Please do. I'll obviously trade it for Ophiomancer if it comes over. I won't trade it for the Snake or the Bloodsoaked Champion because my opponent can replace them so easily. So, which is the best I can do is kind of hold off this two damage. It feels like in most games that should have been a massive victory, but the way things are panning out for me thus far in this match, it didn't feel like much at all. If I draw a land here, I'm in okay position. Wow. Okay. Oh my goodness. This is okay. That's actually a thing. So my opponent not only has a Sol Ring but also a Skullclamp. Freaking hell. Okay. I feel like this is ridiculously over right now. Even. Do I even swing with this guy? No, because he gets one at the beginning of each upkeep. So it doesn't even do anything. It just would kill my Reclamation Sage. So he can get two cards for free every turn. Well, for one mana. It's just outrageous. If I draw a mana, I get to kill Ophiomancer and my life looks a little better, but what was the chance of that ever happening, to be honest? I'm gonna put it out there and say it was close to zero. I guess I will block the snake here because it denies my opponent two cards and I have to try. Stunted Growth doesn't even do anything here now, anymore. It's not even vaguely relevant. There's Mana Crypt, not really even being relevant. This is just such a grotesque beating. I cast this. I have no idea what plays are even any good anymore. Make Freylaze, destroy Skullclamp, lose Freylaze. Guess that's like really all that I can do. It's not even good. I'm still gonna get like beats to face, and my opponent still has four cards. Now I have a Mana Crypt on the board, and a Falkenwrath Aristocrat. Why not? I guess like certain strategies as well, when they get powered up, are just even better. Like this strategy is certainly really very good. When it gets powered up, let's go Tails and shoot myself. Yeah, cool, of course. And there's a forest. So, I guess that's what can happen. Thanks for watching. Wasn't much of a match.